Hi students, question number 14. Planck's constant h, speed of light c, and Newton's gravitational constant capital G are taken as three fundamental constants. Which of the following combinations of these has the dimensions of a length? So four combinations are given. Now we are familiar with the three constants given. Already you have come across Planck's constant h, then velocity of light c, and the gravitational constant capital G. Now this is a question taken from the NEET previous year paper. So such questions and all, now directly you cannot answer. You have to find out by substituting the dimensions in each, so it will drag much time. Random method only we have to go. So randomly, first I will take the option A. So option A, square root of h into capital G divided by c power, velocity of light c whole power 3/2. So this also can be written as square root of h into capital G divided by square root of c cube. C power 3/2 is what? C cube whole power half. So this is a c cube, square root of c cube. So this can be written as together square root of h into g divided by c. Okay, now I am going to substitute the dimensional formula for each. Now the dimensional formula for Planck's constant h is m l square t power minus 1. Already we have derived this. Then the dimensional formula for gravitational constant is m power minus 1 l cube t power minus 2. And the velocity of light c is l t power minus 1, l t power minus 1. This has to be substituted in this square root. Okay, so this now implies square root of, in place of h I will substitute m l square t power minus 1. So this is m l square t power minus 1, okay, into capital G is m power minus 1 l cube t power minus 2. So this is m power minus 1 l cube t power minus 2. So this is totally inside a square root, okay, divided by l t power minus 1, and this is c cube. Okay, so this is a c cube, no, therefore it is a l t power minus 1 whole cube. So that now this is equal to, okay, this is now equal to square root of this m here, m power minus 1. So m and m power minus 1 can be cancelled. You see here m power minus 1 is getting cancelled, and remaining is l power 3, l power 2 will become l power 2 plus 3, 5. So this is l power 2 plus 3 into t power minus 1, t power minus 2. So into t power minus 1, here minus 2 is there. Okay, so this is extended to the denominator. In the denominator, if you take the whole power 3, means l cube, first term is l cube, okay, l power 3, second term is t power minus 3. So this is t power minus 3. Okay, here l power 2 plus 3 is what? L power 5. So this is inside the square root, l power 5. Denominator is l cube, that will come to the numerator as l power minus 3. So totally this is l power 5 minus 3. Okay, and into t power, this minus 1 and minus 2 will be adding, okay, so minus 3. Then it is divided by, okay, this now it is divided by t power minus 3. So that this t power minus 3 and t power minus 3 can be cancelled, and the remaining is what only? Numerator term, 5 minus 3 is 2. So this is a square root of L square. So square root of L square must be equal to what? L. and that should be the dimension of which quantity? It is that of the length. Luckily, we started with the first option itself is correct. Otherwise, what should have happened if the first option was not correct? Then you will have to go for the second and third. So this is trial and error method only. So such questions you should not attend immediately. So in NEET exam, such questions can be attended at the end when you have some spare time. So this is trial and error method only. Anyhow, successfully we have got the option A itself as the right answer. Therefore, now you see here, which is having the dimension of length is the option A. So I will write, therefore, option A is the correct answer. I hope you have understood well. Okay, fine. Question number 15 is the last problem in your textbook exercise. This has been asked in the previous year, JEE, that is IIT Advanced Exam. Little bit tedious, but you have to practice such problems also. A length scale L depends on the permittivity epsilon of a dielectric material. Then Boltzmann constant KB, the absolute temperature capital T, the number per unit volume N of certain particles, and the charge Q of each particle. Which of the following expressions for the length L is dimensionally correct? So left side is L, okay, left side of all these terms is L, that is the length. The right side, which of these four options has the same dimensions as the length? First of all, you should know that it is a highly advanced question for your level, because some of the terms like the dielectric, permittivity and Boltzmann constant and all, it will be meeting you either in the second volume of your class 11 and the first volume of class 12 only. Anyhow, I will tell you one method. Randomly you have to substitute the dimensions or the units of each physical quantity and you can find out. But now I will tell you the right option is B for this question. B will be the right answer. Let us go from the answer. Then you can decide how to check the others also. Okay. So I am going to take randomly the option B. And before that, the five terms are there. Epsilon is called the permittivity. Okay. By how much the material is going to permit the flow of electric field lines through itself. That is called permittivity. Understand? So, the unit of permittivity I am going to write. The unit of permittivity is coulomb. Coulomb square per Newton. Okay? Per Newton per meter square. This is the unit. Okay? Coulomb square per Newton meter square is the unit of the permittivity. Similarly, I am going to substitute the permittivity of the other constants. So, Boltzmann constant, the unit of Boltzmann constant is joule, okay, that is the unit of energy per Kelvin, joule per Kelvin, which is also equal to what joule? One joule also equal to 1 newton into 1 meter. So, this is also Newton meter per Kelvin, okay, this is the SI unit of what Boltzmann constant. Then the third one is a temperature. So temperature is absolute temperature. They have given absolute temperature. So the unit for absolute temperature is Kelvin, K, capital K. Then N is the number of charged particles per unit volume. Number divided by volume. Number has no unit. But volume is in the denominator. The denominator it is what? It is L cube or meter cube. Okay, meter cube. So, this is a meter power, okay, meter power minus 3, 1 by meter cube. So, it is meter power minus 3 and charge, the charge Q is in coulomb, okay, charge is in coulomb. So, these are the units I am going to substitute randomly in the option B. So, option B I will substitute square root of, okay, square root of. In place of epsilon, what unit I am going to substitute? Coulomb square per Newton per meter square. So this is Coulomb square Newton power minus 1 meter power minus 2 into, in place of Boltzmann constant KB, Newton meter per Kelvin. So this is a Newton meter per Kelvin. Okay, into absolute temperature T is in Kelvin. So this is into K for Kelvin. So I have substituted all the numerator values and their units I have substituted. First I will substitute the units and I will cancel some terms. Then in the denominator number per unit volume, that is m power minus 3. So this is a meter power minus 3 multiplied by Q square. So Q square, it is Coulomb square. So this is what a Coulomb square. I have substituted. Now which are all the units getting cancelled, let us see. Okay. Can you see that C square and C square gets cancelled first? So C square, Coulomb square is getting cancelled. Then here K power minus 1 into K power 1. That is also getting cancelled. Then Newton power minus 1 into Newton power 1. M power 1 gets cancelled. Okay. Then you will see that this also is equal to square root of. Okay. Square root of. After cancelling these terms, what is remaining? M power minus 2, M power 1. So this is M power minus 2. Okay. Plus 1 is remaining. Divided by m power minus 3. So this is remaining. All other terms get cancelled. So this is now equal to square root of m power minus 2 plus 1 is m power minus 1. So this is m power minus 1. This m power minus 3 is coming up as m power plus 3. So this is m power 3 meter cube. So that now this is equal to square root of meter power 3 minus 1, 3 minus 1. So this is equal to square root of a meter square. So this is equal to square root of a meter square is what? Only meter, only meter. So in terms of a unit itself, you can verify. Instead of substituting the dimensional formula, you can substitute units also. So we have now verified that the option B given in the square root is found to have the dimensions and the units of length. So naturally option B must be the correct answer. But my dear students, you keep it in your mind. Such problems and all, you keep it as a last choice. Okay, because it is a random method. Which is correct roughly, we have to guess. Okay, and then if you check A, B, C, the option D may be the right answer sometimes. So the first three options, trial time is getting wasted. So you should be clever in choosing the questions and verifying the options. So such questions you will have to keep at the end, only in the spare time, understand? Okay, now which is the right option is B. Therefore, option B is the correct answer. Okay, students, I hope you must have understood. Fine, see you.